I'm Jessica Cruzan, owner of Soda Kind, and I make everything right here in Hilo, Hawaii.
What I've skipped on this pattern is that little extra zippered pocket, because, I don't know, you don't really need it. Like, I feel like people don't really miss it if they didn't know that it wasn't supposed to be there, and it kind of keeps it kind of smooth and clean on the front. It just sort of, my opinion, it makes it go a lot faster. These are pretty fast to make anyway. So when I sew them, I roll the edge down just a little bit to give it like a nice little lip, and then I just stitch right along that little edge. So it makes it nice and pretty on this side, and still nice and pretty on this side, and then you don't have to worry about any showing at the top. the secret to top stitching, don't stop. Keep going. Because even if you're like a little wavy, if you keep going, it's a smooth wave. But if you stop, it's going to be a jerky, jerky, jerky wave, and you'll see it. So just keep going. Okay. Let's top stitching. So then basically all of our pockets are done. So, all finished, all tops is done, pocket is in. So now I'll put my little wooden tag on there, rivet him on, and then the whole fronts are finished, so we stitch them back, and then we do the lining. Rivets, nail piece, I stick up to the back, take a tag, take a tag down, and you have your little tops, you can just push them down on here right now so that it just holds everything in place, so you can stack them all up, and then when you're done stacking and getting them ready, then you just go press, 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 and you're all done. Makes this. So the little cup on the bottom, you can feel the little rivet on the bottom seat into the little cup, and just press down. So then there, all nice and riveted down without crushing it. So the back's on and then we're all good. Okay, so that is all the bodies put together. We just have to do the corners, and then that part is all done. Now all of our our bags are all put together. It's wrong side out. Corners are all boxed. These get set aside. Same marriage. The label's all sewn in, the pockets are in. When I cut these out, I mark from the edge a little bit, a little point here, and I mark, you can kind of see it, from here to a little point here, and that's where you start and stop for your zipper. When I cut out the lining, I mark them all at the same time, so it's way faster. So, this is my zipper. This is a metallic finish nylon zipper because we are in Hawaii and it is very humid. Metal zippers weld themselves shut before you can even use them. So I would like the look of the metallic metal zippers, but it's nylon, so you can cut it with scissors and you can sew over it, which is awesome. So much easier to use. So you take one end, you open it just enough, and you fold it back on itself, quarter inch, so you can you see how it folds in on itself, and so then this fold stays even with this, so you line that up with your edge. So we're basting the zipper on, and then you stop at the mark down at the other end, so you don't sew it to all the way to the end. You just stop at the mark. So, this end, stop at that mark. This end, fold it over, and just sort of baste it on. Now, this is the cork for the top piece. Black cork. Fabric backing, a little fuzzy on there. So now I just lay these on top. And this part is stitched on. I don't change my foot because I don't really care about having it right up against the zipper. I think a little bit of the zipper showing is kind of nice. But the foot rides right along the edge of the teeth. when you get down to this end, you put your needle in, put your needle all the way down where that edge is, and you lift up your zipper and you pull him to the side so that it's out of the way. So that's how that goes. See, the zipper comes out of there at that top, or the bottom edge, and this is sewn in. And that's it, all sewn in. So the beginning, and then, oops, the end part right there. So I have found the easiest way to do this one is, okay, so then my mark's on the other side's here, back, I take it this way and I line him up this way. So I line up the edge of your lining to the edge of your lining. You line up your mark here with your mark here, and you start tacking it down that way. Okay, and then when you get down to this one, you fold him over, just like you did the other side. So it's like nice and folded over, lines up with your little mark, and you baste him down. So that side is all basted. And this side is all pasted in. Okay. Now, so this one, I find that it's easier this way than from the top the other way. Because if you sew it from this direction, like this, you're going to have to pull the zipper out of the way. You'll have to pull the zipper out of the way. And then you can have run the risk of pulling this too far over, and then you don't catch it. So I feel it's easier to sew it upside down, because you get more control. Okay, and then to the bottom of the zipper, the needle is down all the way. So lift your foot, move your zipper. Oops, can you see? You move the zipper out of the way. Lay everything back down where it goes. And keep stitching. As you can see, like right here where it tries to pull, if you do that from the other side, you have a chance of like pulling it so that it doesn't get caught in the seam. So, there he is, all top stitched in. So you can see where they start and stop. And then down here, it just sticks out at the top. And it's all stitched in down there. Okay, now I need a zipper. I have these nice little zipper pulls here. This is a locking pull. So when you slide him on, it's easier to push him because there's a little, I don't know if you can see in there, probably not. Yeah, see that little finger in there that sticks down a little bit? Anyway, so if you push or pull on it, it moves that little finger so that it makes it easier for these to slide on. So you open your zipper up. A lot of people have troubles, but it gets easier the more you do. Put one side on, put the other side on, grab it down here like this, and then you just push with your pull. And you'll feel it click when he goes in the right way. And then you just slide on. Zipper. Okay.
Of course I should have.
And then I like little zipper ends for mine. You can use a fabric tab, whatever, but I like zipper ends because they're faster. So I take my zipper and I fold him up like that. So it's basically kind of the width of your zipper. And you take your little zipper pull or tab and a slidey one. Pushy one. Please all the way. And you can make sure that sometimes it'll get a little bunch right here and you just poke him in. This one did pretty good. So he's like in there nicely. Screw. Okay, little tiny screw. Zipper tab. All nice and pretty. Your zipper is in. I leave them like that for now just because there's no point in opening them up. I have all of them done. You can see better on the red. So everything's finished. Zipper pulls are in. Zipper tabs are on. Screws are in. Now we're going to sew up the sides, box the corners, put in a webbing, and then basically we're done. So I cut the birthing hole strings because it tends to hold them, just makes it easier to work with. And then with these guys, boxing the corners again. I don't measure them, I don't mark them, I've done them 100 times, but you know, normally you flatten out your corner. Take your ruler, mark your line, stitch down your line, and cut them. But I kind of know where they go. And you can do both pockets, or both corners, on one bag if you have it face up. So your bottom piece face up, you can do this one. Make sure your seam allowances are going the same direction. So what I'm doing is like I'm fiddling with this so I can feel the seam allowance here and the seam allowance here, and if you have them going in opposite directions, you can feel them like lock together when you push it like this. You know, you push them together and then you don't have to put a pin in there because you can feel it's already together. We've got our lining finished. You can cut the corners. I don't. And then for the other end, I cut these little guys 2 inches long. Also, must have. So the triangle side, which would be this side, is where I put this one. Then on this side, I drop him in, and I do this guy on this side seam. I open my seam up flat, and I kind of poke this up just a little bit over the edge, just so you have a little bit extra hang. Now that everything is prepped and clipped, and then we pop in our lining, stitch it, top stitch it. So since your zippers are already in, just pull them open, turn them right inside out. So this is the back, make sure you put them, this is the front, make sure they're going the right way. Oh, I flatten this seam out too. Here, let's see down here. Open them up, and I pin it right on top of the other one, so they're lined up. And then it just fits, and I only use two pins to hold the whole thing in. So, now that we have them all pinned and ready, pinned, yeah. So, with the tops of my bags, I stitched them like 3/8. I don't know why, I just have done that forever. Yeah, I don't really have a reason for why I do that, I just do it. For those of us who don't have like a cylinder bed machine where it's just all a flat table, stitch them from the inside, then it doesn't matter because you're not stitching it from the outside. So, berthing. So we poke out all of our seams. See, corners line up nicely. Don't have to pin them, just eyeball those guys. Lines up nicely. So then, closing up the birthing hole, I just roll them down. I don't have time to hand sew it or anything, so I just top stitch them down. Every time I come up with a new bag pattern, my partner and I have Ava night, so we'll have like a big bowl of Ava and poo-poos, you know, like appetizers. So Ava and snacks, and then we come up with a name for the bags, because all of my bags have a Hawaiian name. So we have Ava night in our bag naming ceremony. So these guys, because they're a two-zip hipster, so I call them a kikala, which is the Hawaiian word for hip. Not very exciting, but it sounds nice and Hawaiian. The Bonnie bag by Swoon, I call that a pakeke, which means bucket in Hawaiian. But yeah, so they all have a Hawaiian name. Everything all sewn in, stuff their insides back in. I just like roll it down just a little bit, get it in place, reach in, push it where it needs to go. Yeah, the NCW I do totally differently, so like, I do it where you don't have to iron at all. So I do the card slots out of cork, so they aren't folded, they're like cut. Yeah, you gotta play with your Jiki, you gotta make friends. It's probably just a tension issue. So for this part, I have to usually crank up my tension a little bit because I'm stitching the top stitching from the inside because I have a flatbed machine. So my top stitching is underside stitching. So it's all nicely top stitched around. I do my overlap here at the back where I just, you know, I start here, go around, and then I stop here. So it overlaps like 4 or 5 stitches. And then that locks it in so you don't have to back tack or anything. And on the inside, you can barely see where they overlap. So. And then he's done. Inside, a little zipper hangs out over here. So, yep. So when I'm top stitching this edge, so this is the outside, right? And you don't see any of the inside in there because I roll it down inside. I roll it just a hair, like an eighth of an inch maybe, down so that it's just below that top edge. And it leaves a really nice finish on the inside and it makes it a nice finish on the outside. You don't have anything like poking up the top because that's sort of a pet peeve of mine when they poke up it from the top. I lay it all like this so it doesn't get twisted. So that's how it goes into your slider. Yes, this is 1-inch cotton webbing. That's all I use for the webbing. It's 100% 1-inch cotton webbing. And cheaptrims.com has like, I don't even know how many colors to choose from. It's ridiculous. So then I just clip it until it's ready. I poke 2 holes in it, stick rivets, done. And then this guy can go off to its new forever home.